got bail. A bail for Sadhvi Pragya, one of the main accused in this particular case. This is the Bombay High Court, which was all set to pronounce today its order on the bail pleas of Sadhvi Pragya as well as Col Purohit, the prime accused in the 2008 Malegaon blast case. In news that's just coming in right now, there has been relief there with the Bombay High Court granting bail to Sadhvi Pragya.
Yes, important to note that the two main accused had...
Let's go across to Vinayak joining us over the phone line with further details. Vinayak, talk us through the latest proceedings there in the court. Relief that's coming in for Sadhvi Pragya. The Bombay High Court has granted her bail.
Yes, finally, that's a huge relief for Sadhvi Pragya Singh after years of trying to secure bail from both the NIA court as well as the Bombay
court. As well as the Bombay High Court. Let us remind our viewers that Sadhvi had been trying to procure bail from the courts for almost 6 years now through various bail applications filed on various grounds, from merit to health. She earlier claimed that she suffered from cancer. Then she backtracked that claim. Now, last year, after the NIA gave her a complete clean sheet from the Malegaon 2008 blast case, this is the first time that Sadhvi Pragya Singh will finally come out and she has got bail.
Vinaya, what else can you get us as far as Lieutenant Colonel Purohit there is concerned? He had moved the Bombay High Court as well for his bail plea to be heard, both bail pleas that were being heard today itself.
Yes, let us understand. Right now, the Bombay High Court has not yet pronounced judgment on Colonel Purohit's bail application. But let us understand, there are basic differences between the bail application filed by Sadhvi Pragya Singh and by Colonel Purohit. The circumstances, the evidence against both the accused vary completely. So while the NIA had given a complete clean sheet to Sadhvi, that has not been the case with Colonel Purohit whatsoever. He has, in fact, not been given a clean sheet by NIA. More than that, the whatever causes stated by Colonel Purohit in his bail plea have been submitted to the court. The NIA has gone ahead and opposed the bail application and said that all those circumstances which are favoring Colonel Purohit should be heard by the trial court only after the trial begins, and right now NIA cannot say anything about it.
So but Vinaya, tell us, what does this really mean for the ATS as well? Because the ATS has also charge sheeted 12 of these people, and one of those included Sadhvi Pragya along with Colonel Purohit. But the fact that she has gotten bail, what does the ATS have to say today?
See, the ATS is now no more in the picture. Whatever the ATS had said a few years ago is not being considered by the NIA. So, in fact, if you see the arguments from Colonel Purohit, you will understand that the same circumstances, the same evidence which was produced by the ATS, that's the same evidence that has been attested by the NIA as well. In Sadhvi's case as well, whatever evidence was produced by the ATS, that evidence was not negated by the NIA, but the NIA stood on the same grounds and in fact went ahead to oppose the bail. The only difference being Sadhvi had initially said that she does not own the bike which was used in the blast, 2008 Malegaon blast.
Okay.
And she had already sold it to somebody else who was using it. So if you see the evidence produced by ATS in the case remains to be the same. The NIA has in some way taken from it, but this is in complete contradiction to the ATS's previous stand where the ATS had considered Sadhvi as an accused and opposed her bail plea.
That's right. Many, of course, had seen the NIA completely change the allegations, so to say, against the two. This is conditional bail, of course. Further update on the court's hearing, which is still on. The other main accused here regarding Lieutenant Colonel Purohit.
Well, news that's coming in. Colonel Purohit's bail plea has been rejected. As our colleague Vinaya was also telling us, that the bail plea that petitions had been filed were on different grounds altogether. So while one of the prime accused in this case, Sadhvi Pragya, has got bail today, the other one, Colonel Prasad Srikant Purohit, his bail plea has been rejected by the court today. Both of them were the prime accused in the 2008 Malegaon blast case. Relief coming in for, of course, Sadhvi Pragya, but for Colonel Purohit, his bail plea has been rejected.
Our correspondent Faizan Khan getting us further inputs here on this. Grounds of which Colonel Purohit's bail has been rejected. Can you please give us those details there, Faizan?
Well, in fact, what we have seen inside the Bombay High Court, the court has granted bail to Sadhvi Pragya Singh on the bond of 5 lakh rupees and other father, Col Purohit. His bail has been rejected by the Bombay High Court. What we know so far, the grounds being given. As we know already, the NIA has said that they don't have any concrete evidence against Sadhvi Pragya Singh and other four accused. Looking at this, the court has said that Sadhvi haven't influenced any of the witness in this case, and hence the bail has been granted to her. What she knows so far in this case, this is one of the big cases in Malegaon 2008 and 2006. In this case, which we have seen so many twists and turns, like in 2008, where the ATS have probed this Malegaon blast case, and after which the case was transferred to CBI, and after which the case was transferred to NIA. NIA, there was difference found in the NIA investigation and the ATS investigation. Although in 2016, the ATS Mumbai have arrested almost 13 Muslims, saying that these are the people who are involved in the 2006 Malegaon blast case. After the case was transferred to CBI, CBI has agreed with the ATS probe, whatever the ATS has said. But when in 2008, the investigation led by ATS chief, who was the martyred in 2011 case,
right.
There are some other right-wing Hindu groups are involved in this.
All right, we understand the history of this case here, but Faizan, also wanting to understand with further input there from you on what's taken place right now, the conditions under which Colonel Purohit's bail plea has been rejected, what has the court stated there? Stay with us, the lawyer speaking out on this, let's take a listen in.
Is out. I'm now joined by one of the counsel of Sadhvi Pragya Singh Thakur, advocate Shyam Devani. Let's have a word with him and get to know, sir, a very first reaction to you after the whole judgment is out.
We are really very happy that finally, after a long period of 9 years, she will be out. Now, ultimately, we feel that the justice is prevailed, and the conclusions drawn by NIA in the supplementary charge sheet has ultimately found favour with the Honourable Court, and the Honourable Court has ordered for the release of bail.
Sir, we had seen that this was a very long procedure when in a bail and rejection of bails, did took place, appeal for bail and rejection of bail did took place. Finally, the verdict is out. What was the kind of main argument this time in the hearing?
See, basically the allegations against Sadhvi were based on two things. Firstly, that the scooter which was used in the Malegaon blast was belonging to her, and NIA, after reassessing the entire material, came to the conclusion that that scooter was sold way back in the year 2004. And secondly, the allegations were she participated in two meetings, that is Bhopal and Faridabad. So as far as Faridabad meeting is concerned, in which it is alleged that conspiracy was hatched in Faridabad meeting, there was absolutely no evidence of her participation. And in Bhopal meeting, as such, there was no incriminatory material. So basically, this case was based on these two things. So we are yet to get the copy of the judgment. So probably, the Honorable Court has found that whatever advanced arguments we advanced, our team has advanced, that there is some substance in it.
So over here is Advocate Shyam Devani, while talking to NewsX, comes out and says that how it is a 9-year-old journey of Sadhvi Pragya Singh Thakur. In fact, sir, talking to you, what is the kind of reaction that Sadhvi Pragya Singh Thakur since morning was hoping? Because today was the day that after 9 years long, her appeal finally has come out.
Everybody is bound to be happy, because unfortunately she is landing in jail since last about 9 years, as I said, that she is also suffering from dreaded disease. So everybody is bound to be happy.
So smiles on the face out there after the verdict that comes out from Bombay High Court. With video journalist Shubroto, this is Uvashi Khona for NewsX.